push me, and then just touch me, till I can get my satisfaction. 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 Satisfaction.
Push me, and then just hurt me, till I can get my satisfaction. 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 Satisfaction.
Okay, welcome to Satisfaction. We're back here in the Lincoln King limo, and we've got some internationals, I must say.
Oh, yeah,
international. Yes, superstars. You are, you're being a bit of a superstar.
Yeah.
Got Trudy now, you star in the bill.
Yep.
And I'll also
play June Ackland.
June. She's very serious, June, isn't she?
Yeah, she's not much fun.
No, she isn't. And you've been doing what, over 20 years of this?
I think it's 21.
21.
1983, you both started. And Mark, you started at the same time?
I started at the same time, yeah.
So what was that like? 20 years ago, you went for a casting for a show you didn't know much about.
We just joined up for a month's show. It was 2 weeks rehearsal and 2 weeks filming. And then 21 years later, we're in the back of a limo.
Driving around.
Did you ever think you'd go to this distance?
No, absolutely no. It was just, after that first play was done, it was a TV play, part of a series of possible pilots, we got phoned up 6 months later and they said, we're going to make a series of 12 episodes. We're going to call it The Bill. Do you want to come and play? And we said, yes.
Do you ever get bored? Do you find like 20 years on and you're like...
Well, there are days when you get bored, but on the whole, it's gone incredibly quickly, which I think usually means you're enjoying yourself.
It does, because I was going to say, most people's jobs last about, 5 years before you're like, I'm out of this company, and you've been doing it for so long.
Yeah.
Did you get service leave?
Fireproof, bomb-proof.
I'm not sure, yeah.
Because the acting in The Bill is, to me, so raw and so real. It's more, it's such a drama because you're so active, it's always going.
Yeah.
Do you do your own stunts?
I don't do any stunts at all. He does.
You just do the running.
Yeah, I do the running. He loves stunts.
I love all the fighting.
The fighting,
the fighting is great.
You rough up a bit, don't you?
It's terrific. Of course, we don't really hit each other.
Oh, really?
But whenever it gets... No, it's not real.
What?
It's not real.
It's not real. Really?
It's a program.
But whenever something is a bit too dangerous, then stuntmen are coming.
So how well
but
does he look like you?
It takes a lot, actually, for you to use a stunt person.
But I can't say I do all my own stunts, of course.
So do you know your stunt person? Or is it just the back of the head, really?
In actual fact, there's lots of times when a stuntman will come in and double as one of our lady actresses.
Yes, they wear a wig.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
There's one little guy called Nick Gillard who's really, he's shorter than me, actually.
Yeah.
Very, very slight. And he puts on a wig that looks like me.
Oh, so he plays you as well. And you're in there, go for it. Fantastic.
Oh, Nick's amazing. He's a dwarf.
Yeah.
But he works on all the Star Wars films.
Oh, wow.
And Mission Impossible, and he's great. He's fantastic.
Yeah. And yet he's always behind the scenes, in a sense.
Yeah.
Interesting career, that one.
Richer than we are, I
want to say.
He once told me if he stopped work today, he had enough to spend £1,000 a week for the rest of his life.
Yeah.
That would be
nice. And then he is a top stuntman, even though he is a dwarf.
A dwarf. Is it hard? Because how many countries does The Bill air in?
I think it's about 37.
Yes, 37.
What's got some repeat fees from Azerbaijan?
Wow. Yeah. One cent a repeat?
Yeah.
So you're dubbed in different languages?
You're Nick.
Yeah.
Yes.
Have you actually ever seen them?
I have actually. In Singapore, I caught a cable channel where we were dubbed into Chinese or something.
That would just look wrong, Because you've got, you've got this London accent and then you've got this Asian accent, which is just kind of a bit warped, isn't it?
Very strange.
You're sort of like thinking, I had a hard night, there's just something wrong with the television.
We met in UC last night.
Lunatic
as I am. Now, you're here in Melbourne.
Mm-hmm.
It's not the first time you've been here.
Not first time I've been in Australia, it's the first time I've been to Melbourne.
First time to Melbourne and Australia. So what do you think of Melbourne?
Love it.
What have you done?
Absolutely love it. We've done lots of radio interviews. We went on Bert, we met Bert.
Yeah, good old Bert.
He's cool, isn't he? What a gentleman Bert is.
Good laugh.
Wonderful gentleman and fun.
Yeah. Fun, indeed.
We went to the Grand Prix Ball last night where we met him.
Yes, that was fun.
And then we're going to the Grand Prix tomorrow.
Nice.
And I've spent the afternoon walking the entire length of Melbourne.
It's not that big though, so.
It's pretty big. It's up pretty to there big. And back was pretty big. We went all around Victoria Market, so did
you. Yeah, I was saying you were liking the Victoria Market.
Well, I think it's very much like a couple of markets. It's bigger, it's larger. But it's very much like a
Petticoat Lane,
in
I guess.
In London,
yeah. Well, more than Spitalfields markets. Yeah. It's a bit like Victoria Market.
I've bought Ugg boots for my daughter.
I was going to say, what's with the art? Everybody wants to buy Ugg boots.
For my missus, but I've also found some Paul Frank stuff.
Oh, there you go.
Which my daughter loves.
The thing that satisfies me is that our Australian industry is growing. You know, we've got Nicole, we've got Russell as the two top stars in the world. We've got our music part of things where we're having number one hits around the world.
Thanks to you.
Started
it, really.
And Danny Minogue is still making hit records, so Young Talent Time's still in there somewhere.
What satisfies me? Food. Fish.
What satisfies you?
Oh, I'll stop it.
Come on.
Spaghetti, actually.
Spaghetti? Any type of sauce?
Well,
because you're sucking on all that.
Yes, yeah. And something meaty.
Something meaty.
Very meaty.
Meaty, messy spaghetti.
That's a mama.
What satisfies me? Being around my friends and having a good old-fashioned laugh.
Good hard working people, you know.
Absolutely. 400 horse, brake horsepower, actually. Throbbing engine.
Pretty, you've got relatives here as well, don't you?
Yeah.
They've all immigrated to Australia, have they?
Yeah.
And you didn't.
Ago.
Why didn't you?
Well, my dad was brought up over here until he was about 8. My grandmother lived here most of her life.
Yep.
My great grandfather lived in Sydney most of his life. And so I've got aunts and uncles and cousins and I've got about 400 actually relatives.
That's a lot. So and then the move, you're quite happy in England.
I love England.
Yeah, yeah.
I really love London. I'm very much a London person.
A London girl.
I love travelling. Absolutely love travelling. I must say, the atmosphere here is fantastic. And the Australians, I'm not just saying this to be creepy.
No, no.
But the Australians are so nice. They are. They're so nice.
Get over this. We are.
I really, really like them. Everybody's really just laid back and friendly.
Because you're a bit of a celebrity here. Is it good to get that back? You know, it's your first time in like... You don't get that response in London, do you?
Anymore? Well, you do a little
not
bit.
Not like that.
No.
I think because we're
superstars here.
It's extraordinary. Yeah. I mean, we can't believe.
People are so nice to us in England.
Yeah. No, they're not.
No. They tend to leave you.
They do the death grip.
Oh.
Get out the bill!
Yes, or else they go.
It was an Australian accent, but that was supposed to be a London accent, wasn't it?
Yeah, or else they go, yeah, of course, I never watch it. I don't really watch it.
Yeah,
but,
yeah. Oh, I've seen you there, Mark. Oh, yeah, all that. But can I have a fight on an autograph?
Yeah. It's not for me, it's for me auntie.
Yes. Gotta downplay it.
It's for me auntie John.
Yeah, right, dear Peter, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. It's pretty much like that. So your first time in Australia, how long ago was that?
I first came here in 1983.
83,
yeah.
Wow.
This is my grandma who's died now.
But your grandmother has a little fetish of plastic, I hear.
Well, she's dead now, so I can say what
you can say what she wants.
No,
tell me about the plastic story.
She's a bit like Edna Everidge, actually, because she her flat was just all the sofas were covered in plastic, the curtains were plastic. And she said, it's so easy to just wipe down and keep clean.
Because
you'd sit on it in the summer and just stick to everything, just kind of slide.
And you had to sleep on the floor.
And I had to sleep on the floor.
So good, good experience.
Luckily, the carpet wasn't covered in plastic. Well, that could have been.
We could do plastic mats. I mean, really. So how long did you stay in there for?
2 weeks.
2 weeks in plastic world.
Yeah.
So oh my God. No wonder.
Connect Sydney with plastic.
Yeah. And when was your next trip? You didn't come back for how long? 10 years later, I went, no way. Or just the funeral and said, thank goodness, I don't want any of it.
No, we didn't come with the funeral. I came over to present a Logie Award.
Oh, the Logies,
which
yes.
Which is much more glamorous. And they put me up in really... And that's the last time I was in Melbourne.
There you go.
It's raining, sorry.
Well, Melbourne weather, we
but
turned it on.
London weather.
London
weather.
Make you feel at home. We're going to do a quick 10. This is a little section we do. Just quick questions and you fire them off straight away. Puss, 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 puss. okay? Something that you can't leave home without.
Mascara.
Mascara. Yourself?
My clothes.
Your clothes.
Me.
Okay, what's your favourite TV show?
Oh, God. Oh, right.
What do you watch?
Gosh.
It's all right, it's quick.
Yeah.
No, it's not very quick.
Not very quick.
Come back to that. Why are you, why are you thinking, yeah, we'll give you some think time?
Yeah.
Yourself?
West Wing.
West Wing, okay. Interesting.
I don't know, I don't watch a lot of TV.
No? Too busy making it. Something you've always regretted then.
I can't go there.
Come on, come on. Come on, go there, go there. Oh, yes, you can. Get the wine, go there.
Oh, God, I can't.
What did you do?
What? What did I do? I've got a deep and dark and terrible past.
That's what we're here for.
Yeah, but I'm not going to say that.
Oh, come on. What about yourself?
I've always regretted not buying four houses when we first started the
build. I'll regret not buying the build, don't you?
Yeah. Okay.
Not having shares in the build.
Bill. Damn, that's a shame. You never know. Yeah. Cops or robbers?
Robber.
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 Robber. Oh, you want to play robber. The opposite. Your favourite holiday destination?
The Maldives. I love the Maldives.
Maldives,
I
yeah.
Like the Maldives.
I like Thailand.
Thailand. Yep, good place. You're saying, have you got a motto?
Medeas.
Medeas.
Like
oh, Medeas.
Yeah.
No, no motto. No. We're going to get you a motto.
I like one.
Live now.
Yeah.
I've got one which I sort of use a lot. It's if you understand everything, things are exactly as they are. If you understand nothing, things are exactly as they are.
Okay. Ponder on that one. Okay, your worst habit. Reveal that. What do you do?
Yeah.
I know, it's tough. It's meant to be quick, off the top of your head. Come on, don't
speak. I think my worst habit. I think I'm too nice to people.
Too nice. A bit like your character.
Picking my feet.
Picking your feet. Ooh. Yeah. Okay, what's your best body part then?
I know what he's
Yeah, yeah, what's yours? Go on, tell me. Tell me that one.
I'm not going to say.
Well, what's yours?
I think my eyes are my best.
Your eyes, okay.
Not my eyes under them.
No.
We once had a testicle competition at work.
Say that.
You can, it's fine.
No, I won.
You won?
Yes.
What's it, how do you judge something like that?
The size that matters.
Okay, if you ever won $1 million, what would you buy? No.
All right.
Prove it.
Oh my God. During the break, we're going to have a break coming up.
It's
getting a bit hot in here. Okay, if you won $1 million, what would you buy?
A hospital.
Wow. That's interesting.
A hospital for people in Africa or something.
Okay. And yourself?
A submarine.
Well, there you have it. That was the quick long 10. We'll be back after the break in the Linker King limo on Satisfaction.
What's happening?
Dude, you speak on Satisfaction? Like, I got this call, dude?
Jamal and Tell-Ball.
Oh, Mitchell.
Quality here.
Everybody wants to be Irish. Get some tits. Okay. You should probably do that again. Sorry, because I heard the thing coming on. Just as
that was a stopwatch.
Oh, was that a stopwatch?
Yeah, we missed the stopwatch on my camera light.
All right.
But we'll do it again.
Who owns the car?
No. I don't know. You want to scratch it? Okay.
So it's clean.
Okay, welcome back to Satisfaction. We're in the luxurious Linker King limo, joined here by Mark and Trudy from The Bill. If you've been watching, during the break, I saw somebody's testicles. No, that didn't really happen. No, seriously.
Weren't mine.
Now, I'm going to talk about it. You sure? You're getting on now, I mean, really. Now, I'm noticing there's a big difference between the English acting and, say, the American acting.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys aren't into the Botox and the facelifts and all that. It's all about, as you can see, what is it about that in England that it's, you know,
well, I think it's catching on, actually.
Some of them do it.
Yeah, it is catching on.
I find it really worrying. I hate it. Nothing would induce me to do that.
Yeah? No. Do you get fearful sometimes, like, because the new and up and coming young up and wannabes are sort of moving in?
Yeah,
you kill them?
Yeah. Kill them off.
Yeah?
Get rid of them.
You get rid of them.
I think if you start doing that, you've lost it, actually. If you start... in my head, I'm still 25, so yeah. I just don't look at myself.
No, you don't act 25. What? So can I ask your age?
53.
Very proud. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
How is it at 50? Because, you know, people say 40 is embracing, okay. Is great, no, so actually, the 50 is...
I hate it being 40. I find 40 really depressing. But
why is that? 50
is fine, actually, quite nice.
Because you clocked over and you went,
just
what the hell?
Suddenly going 40. But now 50 is the new 60.
It is. I don't know. 40 is probably the other way around a little bit.
I think it is.
Yeah, what about yourself? Well, you know, your acting style is compared to American acting style. Would you ever get into American market?
I'd love to. I'd love to go to America. Work.
Is it hard though for someone like you from England?
Well, I've never given it a go. I mean, there's lots of British people in America as there are Australians. I've never ever given it a go. Maybe someday I will.
So where do you go from here? I mean, you've been doing 50 years. Sorry, turn that down.
50 years?
The bill. It feels like it. I mean, where do you go? How many more years are you going to go for?
Well, I'm actually back home. I've left the show.
You have left the show? Oh, yes, you're out.
Gone, yeah.
Oh, so now what?
We'll
wife see. And kids and just chilling.
Yeah. 21 years of DIY to do, I think.
Yes. And just rake those repay fees and let's
go.
Another
job already.
I've got another job.
Oh, I'm setting up.
An episode of Heartbeat.
Oh, okay. And,
which is a very popular British series.
It's over here as well.
But your character's going to be very sad because you two had a bit of a love interest on the screen.
He does the dirty on June.
I have to say, but it's left very open, so, you know, never say never.
Never say never.
I might go back in it again.
Let's go for it. Has there ever been, like, off-screen chemistry in those... I know you're married now, got, you know, kids and stuff, but...
No, no? We like each other very much.
I tried, but she wouldn't have
No, we get on really, really well, but no... Nothing like that.
Is there stuff
like
that going on?
Otherwise our partners wouldn't let us come out here.
No, I was going to say, is there stuff like... You guys work with each other how often? How many hours in a week?
Well,
you can actually spend. You can actually spend more time with the actors on the show than you do with your family, you know, which
Yeah, that's what I mean. So why hasn't this happened? Why haven't you, like, gone, you know what?
Because we know each other too well.
I never see my wife anymore and you're it.
Yeah. No, I think we have known each other an awfully long time. I feel like
brother and sister.
Best mate.
Trudy feels like my sister.
You're right, 50 is getting under 60, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's starting to feel like your mum. Terrible.
Well, there are new people joining the programme who go, oh, I've been watching it since I was 3.
Oh,
you know,
wow.
That makes you feel, I think you might have said that to me.
No,
actually,
no.
People joining the programme.
I'm a lot older than I look, remember that. So where do you want to go from here then? Where do you see your role in the future?
I've got no idea. I mean, when I leave, which I will have to leave quite soon.
Are they pushing you out?
No, not as far as I know, but then, you know, you can only stay in the police for so long.
True.
Long service leave. I'd like to go before I get pushed, to be honest.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'd love to do some theatre. I'd love to do some telly if anybody gives me.
Because you used to be a dancer way back. You used to do that. What happened to that?
I didn't know.
Can't you tell by the sexy legs? I mean, they're holding up.
I used to be a teacher as well.
Oh, what?
Maybe I go back to
and
teacher.
You didn't go down that way? Quite surprised.
Neither of those things were really...
No dancing, no single out, no album. What's going on? You know?
Well, that's now. Back then, it was different.
Not the done thing.
No, it's true.
French champagne, oysters, and the biggest salt and pepper chili crab known to mankind. Can I be more than satisfied?
What satisfies me? Channel 31 satisfies me. Since I got rid of cable, because I couldn't watch 31 when cable was on.
So, how would you like to go out?
I don't want to die, that's for sure.
Come on.
No, I really don't want
We love a good death.
No, I know, but
no.
I don't want Atkin to die off.
But imagine the funeral. Imagine the weeping fans and the...
I don't think I could bear to see Hope killed off. You said you wouldn't mind.
I'd love to drink myself to death.
Yeah.
Because you're an alcoholic.
It's a strange
happy
thing to
character.
Say, isn't it? But I would, yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have much input on what you do in your character anyway, or
well,
not?
That particular storyline was my suggestion.
Yeah. So they approached you and said...
Well, they were going to put Carver back into uniform for some technical reason that was happening in the real Metropolitan Police. And I said, well, don't we give them a few problems? And they did.
So the fascinating thing about it is you actually don't drink.
No, I don't drink at all.
So, and yet your character's a complete pisspot.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you just fell off. Because I swore you were pissed last night.
No, he wasn't.
I was quite surprised.
He gets high on atmosphere.
Yeah, it was feeding off your energy, I think. Yeah. I must. Do you remember anything from last night?
Yeah, no, I was very good, actually. I'm jet lagged.
You are jet lagged.
Oh, I didn't mind talking.
So, as a copper, is there a law that you would love to bring in?
These questions are really difficult.
They are, I know. No, just bang, there you go.
Yeah. Well,
I mean, because you obviously your characters
are
based on real...
If I was the law I'd like to bring in here in Melbourne,
yeah,
is to make sure that all the taxi drivers knew where they were going.
Oh, okay. You got to gripe about taxi drivers. The Indian, right? Was he Indian?
We've had so many taxi drivers
so
who don't know where they're
different
going.
Taxi drivers. Right. And when one did know where he was going, he didn't believe him.
Are you sure?
Absolutely.
Are you sure you're going there? So bring in a law. Well, because the English taxi drivers have to study quite a lot.
Between 3 and 5 years to drive.
And know every street the shortcut way.
Yep.
Yeah.
Which is why we find that a bit strange.
Right. We'll bring that law in. What about yourself? Yeah. Would there be ever a law you'd love to bring in?
I think people should have a look at the drugs laws.
The drug, what, bring more in for you, or make it easier?
And I don't take drugs.
No.
I think a sensible attitude towards other narcotics, especially back home, although that started, you see.
So we're talking legalising marijuana or something like that.
That's about it, though. That's
so that's a pretty big statement, because people will hold us to such thing. I mean, America has this such a taboo about it.
Yeah, well,
you know, drugs.
They're not letting you in now, after
saying
that.
Drugs have really only been illegal since about the 1930s.
Everybody used to take cocaine in the 1920s.
Yeah. Opium and all that.
Not that I want people to take drugs, but I think
a smarter way of dealing with it.
I think legalising.
Have you ever had a criminal record or been into the law in any way, in trouble?
No, I said the other day, the only thing was that a friend of mine actually borrowed my moped when I was at university.
Okay.
And without my knowledge, and then got stopped by the police. And
did you dob him in? You said it was stolen.
Dob him in? See, I don't understand what that means.
Towel.
Oh,
lag.
No,
do you know lag?
Lag.
Yeah.
I didn't have insurance for him to drive, so I had to pretend that I'd given him permission to take. So then I was done for permitting driving with no insurance.
Oh,
so that's my only criminal record, which is very unfair.
So I bit you on the bum.
Mm.
What about yourself?
Oh, completely spotless.
Spotless.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Come on, I want to know the juice. Tell me.
Absolutely, completely. Never been
what has
in
he
trouble
done?
In
what
my is, life.
Ever. You've got a criminal record as long as my arm. I know it.
My satisfaction. 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 Satisfaction.
Less is more. More is more, and a lot is not enough.
Channel 31, I have to do Channel 31. What do you mean? What, professionally or sexually or... what really satisfies me? Swimming in the ocean. There you go.
Push me, and then just hurt me. Do I get my satisfaction?
We'll go into a bit about the characters and... the storylines, are they based on real stories? Where does the information come from?
Some of them are. I mean, I think sometimes they trawl the newspapers and look for storylines that way, some of the writers. We've got police advisors on set all the time, so they presumably get stories from there.
Do you feel like a police officer, a real one? You're almost there.
No, not really.
No?
No, not really.
Just reading lines and off you go, no?
spooky occurrence on the village, you can write a story, because it takes about 6 to 8 weeks to be broadcast. You can record an episode, which then becomes a current story. So it's broadcast, and say it was, I don't know, a rape case or something.
Yeah.
And then there might be a rape case in reality that
happens at the same time.
Mirrors real life. Yeah. We've also become a bit of a criminal's burglar's handbook.
Actually, because it shows you how you
absolutely.
Yeah. I was going to say, I've been watching it, and it's like, you know what? I think you just taught everybody how to do something.
No, we've done that quite a few times, actually.
Yeah. You have, yeah.
Mistakenly so.
Also, the interrogation room, it's pretty real, and I find that teaches you. I've learnt by watching it, when they say you have the right to remain silent, remain silent.
Yeah, but that implies guilt, you see.
You don't have the remains. You don't have the right to remain silent in Britain.
You don't?
Don't you do anymore? It's changed.
Oh, really?
I think it's changed.
Yeah, you don't have it.
So what do you say now when you're arresting someone on the bill? Shut up! What do you want to know?
You still do your,
bill.
Oh, yeah. I'm arresting you for wearing an offensive shirt. You do not have to say anything that may harm your defence. If you do not mention when questioned something which you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence. Do you understand?
What a line, you know, off by heart.
We say that a lot.
A lot. I bet you do. Well, thanks so much. No, it's not.
It's quite nice.
I thought, look, it's Target. What do you want? If I play English, you know what I mean. Well, thanks so much for being in the back of the limo.
It
was a pleasure. I hope you enjoy the rest of Melbourne.
We will.
Big tour in Australia.
Oh, we've got Grand Prix tomorrow.
Yes. And I hope I see you back again.
Oh, I hope to be back.
Oh, yeah.
We've had a great time.
It's unfair because I got two of you, so I really split the time in half, whereas I could do one-on-one, but anyway, that's it. Well, thanks for watching. I'll see you next week.